हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मनोज कुंडारे, द असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक साइंस। वेलकम बैक टू आवर ई लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द सेकंड सेमेस्टर ऑफ FYBSC कंप्यूटर साइंस इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स। द नेम ऑफ सब्जेक्ट इज बेसिक्स ऑफ कंप्यूटर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द एक्चुअल टीचिंग ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट, वी हैव टू नो सम बेसिक कंसेप्ट। वी नो दैट इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स द circuits are divided into two types. First one is analog circuit and second one is digital circuit. The digital circuits further divided into two types, combinational logic circuit and sequential logic circuit. Let's see what is meant by combinational and sequential logic circuit. The logic circuit in which the output depends on the present input only is known as combinational logic circuit. That means the electronic circuit in which its output depends on present input only is known as the combinational logic circuit. The example of the combinational logic circuit is half adder circuit, full adder circuit, etc. Now let's see the sequential circuit. The logic circuit in which output depends on present input as well as the combination of past input and output is known as sequential logic circuit. That means we can say that the sequential circuit is the circuit in which its output is depends on present input as well as the values of past input and output. Okay, to store this past input and output values, we require one memory element here. That means we can see the difference of the combinational circuit and the sequential circuit is that in combinational circuit we does not require any memory element, while in sequential circuit we require a memory element to store the past input and output values. I hope you all understand the basic difference between the combinational circuit and the sequential circuit. Let's see once again. The combinational circuit is the circuit in which its output depends on totally its present input only, while in sequential circuit its output depends on present input as well as past input output values, and these past input output values are stored in the memory element. I hope you all understand the sequential logic circuit. The sequential logic circuit further divided into two types, asynchronous sequential circuit and synchronous sequential circuit. Why these two types, asynchronous sequential circuit and synchronous sequential circuits? These two types are based on the clock signal. Okay, based on the clock signal. The circuit which uses the clock signal for its operation is known as synchronous sequential circuit, while the circuit which does not uses the clock signal is known as asynchronous sequential circuit. Let's see more details about asynchronous and synchronous sequential circuit. The first one is asynchronous sequential circuit. The clock signals are not used by the asynchronous sequential circuit. Let's see once again, in asynchronous circuits, the clock signals are not used. Okay, the asynchronous circuit is operated through the pulses. So the changes in the input can be changed the state of the circuit. Okay, that means the asynchronous circuit does not uses any clock signal. It uses the pulses. The unclocked flip-flops or the time delays are the memory elements of the asynchronous sequential circuits. The asynchronous sequential circuit is similar to the combinational circuit with feedback. Now let's see the synchronous sequential circuit. This circuit uses clock signal for their operation. The output pulse is the same duration as the clock pulses for the clocked sequential circuit. Since they wait for the next clock pulse to arrive to perform the next operation, so these circuits are a bit slower compared to the asynchronous circuit. Now we can spot the main difference between asynchronous and synchronous sequential circuit is that in synchronous sequential circuit, we require a clock signal for their operation and it is slower than the asynchronous sequential circuit. The synchronization of the output is done with either negative edge of the clock signal or the positive edge of the clock signal. Then the question arises here, what is meant by the clock signal? Let's see the clock signal and its triggering. A clock signal is a periodic signal with a 50% duty cycle. Then what is meant by this 50% duty cycle? The answer is very simple, that when on time and off time of the clock signal or the square wave are same, a square wave is used to represent a clock signal. That means in this clock signal or in this square wave, we can say that this is the on time and this is the off time. These both are same, hence we can say that this is a clock signal. I hope you all understand the clock signal. Let's see once again. The clock signal is a nothing but a square wave which is having the on time and off time same. Okay, then the question arises here, what is meant by triggering? See, in sequential circuit, the output changes with respect to the clock signal. Okay, and the time or the instant at which the sequential circuit changes its output is known as triggering. Okay, now let's see the types of triggering. There are mainly two types of triggering. First one is level triggering and second one is edge triggering. The level triggering is divided into two types, positive or high level triggering, and second one is negative or low level triggering. Okay, and similarly the edge triggering is also of two types. First one is positive or rising edge triggering and second one is negative or falling edge triggering. Let's see one by one. The first one is level triggering. In the clock signal, there are two levels, namely logic high and logic low in a clock signal. That means here we can see that this is the logic high and this is the logic low. That means we can see that the logic low means logic 0 means the open switch, while the logic high means the logic 1, that means the closed switch. I hope you all understand the level triggering. Okay, now let's see the types of the level triggering. The first one is positive or high level triggering. If the sequential circuit is operated with the clock signal when it is in logic high, then that type of triggering is known as positive level triggering. This is highlighted in below figure. This is the positive or high level triggering. What is it? Let's see once again. If the sequential circuit changes its state with the high level of the clock signal, then we can say that the positive or high level triggering. Similarly, if the sequential circuit changes its state or triggers with the negative level of the clock, hence we can say that it is of negative or low level triggering. I hope you all understand the basic difference between positive level triggering and negative level triggering. Okay, now let's see the edge triggering. There are two types of transitions that occurs in clock signal. That means the clock signal transitions either from logic 0 to logic high. That means from logic 0 to logic high, that means this edge. Okay, this edge is called as the rising edge. Okay, or logic high to logic low. That means this type. This edge is called as the falling edge. I hope you all understand two types of edges here. First one is rising edge and second is falling edge. The rising edge occurs when there is a transition from logic 0 to logic 1, and the falling edge occurs when there is a transition from logic 1 to logic 0. Now let's see positive or rising edge triggering. The transition from logic low to to logic high occurs in the clock signal of the positive edge triggering. That means if the sequential circuit changes its state when the rising edge occurs, then we can see that the circuit is of the rising edge triggering or the positive edge triggering. Similarly, if the sequential circuit changes its states or triggers at the falling edge of the clock, then we can say that the circuit is of the negative edge triggered or falling edge triggered. I hope you all understand the basic difference between level triggering and edge triggering. Let's see once again. Level triggering means there are two types of level, level high and level low. Okay. The level high is also called as the positive level triggering when the circuit changes its state at the high of the clock, then we can say that it is of the positive level triggering. And if the circuit changes its state when the low of the clock signal occurs, then we can say that the circuit is of negative or low level triggering. Okay, I hope you all understand the level triggering. Similarly, we can say that the edge triggering. The edge, there are two types of edge. When there is a transition from logic low to high, we get the rising edge. Okay, hence the rising edge is also called as positive edge triggering. When any circuit or the sequential circuit changes its state with the rising edge of the clock, then we can say that the circuit is of the positive edge trigger. Similarly, we get the negative or falling edge when there is a transition from logic high to logic low. Okay, that means this type of triggering. And when the circuit responds to this type of edge, then we can say that the circuit is of the negative or falling edge trigger circuit. I hope you all understand the various concepts like the combinational circuit, sequential circuit, clock signal and triggering, and the most important, the triggering types of the sequential circuit. Mainly there are two types, level triggering and edge triggering. Okay, thank you.